I'm trying to make sure that my little tutorials cover the most common Home Assistant tasks that I see mentioned on various forums and groups. One of those questions people ask regularly is how to set up the Home Assistant energy dashboard to pull in data from their GivEnergy inverter. It's quite a simple process once you know which entities are which, so keep watching and I'll clear that up for you. This guide is going to assume you are using the GiveTCP add-on in Home Assistant, and that it's all up and running. See my latest GiveTCP video for instructions on configuring that if you haven't done it already. There is an alternative integration called GivEnergy Local which will work too, but the entity names are slightly different. Firstly, you need to remember that the energy dashboard is going to display energy data. Energy is power usage over time, measured in watt hours or kilowatt hours. This is not power, which is an instantaneous reading measured in watts or kilowatts. So just to show you the energy dashboard itself, you go to Settings, Dashboards and Energy, and you can add an entity for grid consumption there. You can add your return, that's your exported solar energy. You can add your battery entities for energy going into the battery and energy coming out of the battery. And if you've got a hybrid inverter, you can also add your solar production here too. Now you can just go ahead and add your GiveTCP entities straight into the dashboard here, and you're done. Very simple. In fact, I'll list here on the screen all of the specific entities that you can use. Pause the video if you like and make a note or take a screenshot or something. Well, it would be a really short video if I stopped there, wouldn't it? Yeah, I'm about to tell you why you shouldn't do that. You can, but don't. Let's say you're running that for a year and something breaks, maybe your inverter is swapped out under warranty, or you decide to upgrade. You then go back into the energy dashboard configuration, change the entity to the new one for your new bit of kit. You go and check the dashboard graphs and discover that all of your historical data for that device has disappeared. Well, of course it has. You're now monitoring a different device. The solution to that is to use a utility meter helper. You wrap your GiveTCP energy sensors up in a utility meter, and then you use that utility meter in the energy dashboard instead. If your GiveTCP entity changes, or maybe you move to a different brand, you delete the utility meter and recreate it with the exact same name, wrapping up the new entity instead. All of your historical data is kept. Let me show you how to do that. If you go down to Settings, Devices and Services, and then this Helpers tab at the top, click on Create Helper down at the bottom, and then scroll all the way down and click on Utility Meter. Give the utility meter a name, and in this case I'm going to call it Grid Import Energy Today, and then I'm going to want Import Energy Today Kilowatt Hours. Set the meter recycle to daily and click on Submit. And then obviously we need to go finish here. Forgot about that bit. Right, so you need to leave this a little while so as the sensor you've just created can start to populate with data. If you're not importing anything from the grid, then you might have to wait until you do. So as you can see now, I've now imported 0.1 kilowatt hours so far today according to this sensor. And note it is in kilowatt hours, which is energy. So I close that down. You can now head on over to Settings, Dashboards, Energy, and if I go to Add Consumption, I should be able to do Grid Import Energy Today, and you can see it keeps dropping out. There we go. This sensor here, Grid Import Energy Today, and if I select that, I can now save it. So it's not defined yet, but that'll take a couple of hours. So once this has been given a couple of hours, the data should be available in the dashboard to view itself. I'll just show you there, energy, see nothing in it yet, but it's all waiting, ready to go. Repeat the same thing for all of those other sensors. I'll put them up on the screen again here. The same process for each of those energy sensors, create them as daily cycle ones and then add them into the energy dashboard in the relevant place. So that's the minimal configuration. If you also have a variable energy tariff with different peak and off-peak rates, then things get a little bit more complicated. I have another video all about that, which I'll stick a link to in the description. It involves creating a special utility meter which has tariffs attached to it, and then an automation deals with switching between those tariffs. Go and check out that video if you need to know about that. Anyway, please give this video a like if you found it useful, and subscribe to my channel to see more videos like this. Thank you for watching. Goodbye.
Oh.